Hello, good morning. In our last lecture, we seen the working of half-wave rectifier and center-tapped full-wave rectifier in which two diodes are used. In this chapter, we are going to see only the working of the rectifiers, not in detail parameters on that all. Okay, so in bridge rectifier, so third bridge rectifier is a bridge. Every rectifier is having its separate speciality. Pratyekache kay tari vegvegle kay features ahet. So that features we are going to see in next year. But here today we are going to see the bridge rectifier. Okay. So this bridge rectifier needs a simple transformer. So we know that simple transformer. Okay, so every rectifier requires this because we need to transfer voltage from 230 volt to lower AC voltage. Okay, so we require a simple transformer. Here we don't require a center tap transformer. Okay, so it is a step down. So number of secondary turns are less than the primary turns. So it is a step down. So this is the indication. So this you have to draw the transformer, okay, correctly. If it is step down, then you have to show the secondary turns are less than the primary turns. Okay, we'll detail discussion will be there in the next chapter. Okay, so just see here. Simple transformer, it has two windings, primary and secondary. Okay, so in this bridge rectifier we require four diodes. Okay, so we make a simple arrangement of these four diodes. In your textbook it shows some complex arrangement, but simply we make this as simple as possible. Okay, so you have to arrange the diodes like this, okay, named as D1, D2, D3 and D4. Okay, so arrange like this. Okay, simple way, so it is easy to understand now. So whatever the secondary terminals, you have to connect the point where anode and cathodes are connected to each other. So this is the point where anode and cathode are connected, here common point. Another one is here, anode and cathode. Okay, so you have to connect this. So this curve indicates jumper. There is no connections between this line and this line. It is indicated by this jumper line. Okay, so how we are going to make this connection first? So you have to connect the one of the terminal of secondary to the point where anode and cathode of two diodes connected each other. So here is the same point, here is the, what is the about this point? This cathode and cathode are connected. Here anode and anode are connected. So there is a common point where anode and cathode is connected. Okay, so here is the point and here is the point. So these, we have two points and these two points are connected to the two secondary terminals. Okay, this is simple thing. Then cathode cathodes and here anode and anode are connected to each other. So between these two points you have to connect the load resistance RL. This is the common name for load. Okay, so here, so as this cathode cathode is connected to at this point, upper terminal of this RL generates with a positive potential and lower one is a with a negative potential. How that is generated, let us see. Okay, so now we know that the 230 volt AC is transformed into lower AC voltage. Okay, it may be 6 volt, it may be 12 volt, 15 volt, 20 volt, whatever it may be. Okay, so this is the lower AC voltage. So at the positive half cycle, you very well know that at every half cycle polarities are interchanged. Okay, so at this positive half cycle upper terminal becomes positive and lower terminal becomes negative. So at the negative half cycle upper terminal becomes negative and lower will be positive. So consider first positive half cycle. At that half cycle upper terminal of the transformer is positive and lower terminal becomes negative. So we very well know that if anode voltage, okay, so just you have to see here, okay, if anode voltage is greater than cathode voltage, the diode is forward biased. If anode voltage is less than cathode voltage, it will be reverse biased. Okay, if VA is at higher potential, anode voltage is at higher potential, then it gets forward biased. Okay, or we can say that if VK is at higher potential, what happens? It will be reverse biased. Okay, same thing, just I am changing the wording. If anode voltage is high, then this diode is forward biased. If cathode voltage is high, so this one. If cathode voltage is high, it is reverse biased. Just I am changing the wording. Anode voltage जर कॅथोड पेक्षा जास्त असेल तर तो फॉरवर्ड बायस होतो. एनोड व्होल्टेज जर कॅथोड पेक्षा कमी असेल म्हणजेच कॅथोड व्होल्टेज हाय असेल तर तो रिव्हर्स बायस होतो. एनोड व्होल्टेज हाय असेल तर फॉरवर्ड बायस, कॅथोड व्होल्टेज हाय असेल तर रिव्हर्स बायस. इन शॉर्ट, ओके, आता हे शॉर्टमध्ये आला आपण. इफ एनोड व्होल्टेज इज ग्रेटर दॅन, इफ एनोड व्होल्टेज इज हायर दॅन इट इज फॉरवर्ड बायस, इफ कॅथोड व्होल्टेज इज हायर दॅन इट इज रिव्हर्स बायस. हे लक्षात ठेवायचं. ओके, एनोड वोल्टेज जर हाय असेल तर फॉरवर्ड बायस होतो, कॅथोड वोल्टेज जर हाय असेल तर डायोड रिव्हर्स बायस. ओके, सो हियर यू हॅव टू फाइंड द कंडिशन नाव सिच्युएशन. सो दिस पॉझिटिव इज कनेक्टेड टू एनोड ऑफ दिस डायोड डी वन अँड कॅथोड ऑफ दिस डायोड डी थ्री. वॉट विल द कंडिशन नाव? ओके, व्ही ए इज हाय, फॉरवर्ड बायस. सो दिस पॉझिटिव इज कनेक्टेड टू एनोड. So VA is high for this one and the same voltage is connected to cathode and this is high. Okay, so what is the condition here for this diode D1? VA is high, that means it is forward biased, and here VK is high for diode D3, so therefore it is reverse biased. Got it? So this is most important thing you have to find out, or you have to recognize which one is forward biased and which one is reverse biased. Okay, so by using this criteria, if VA is high, so for diode D1 anode voltage is high, so therefore it is forward biased. So this same voltage is connected to the cathode of D3, here VK is high, so therefore it is reverse biased. Okay, so you have to use this same criteria. So this is the most important, and you have to recognize which one diode is forward biased and which one is reverse biased. Okay, so now consider this one. So this lower voltage is now connected to anode of this diode D2. So here we get a reverse condition of this. Here anode voltage is lower, negative means it is lower voltage. So here anode voltage is lower, so this gets reverse biased. Okay, and here cathode voltage is lower, cathode voltage is lower. What means? It means this is, so here cathode voltage is lower, it means it is forward biased. Okay, so you have to, whatever it may be, you have to keep in mind this, how to recognize the condition of the diode. If anode voltage is higher, it is forward biased. If cathode voltage is higher, it is reverse biased. And here, so opposite of this, if high, it is forward biased. If it is low, so at this condition, this anode voltage is low, so it is reverse biased. So here, VK is high, it is reverse biased. If it is low, so here the same condition, it is low, it is forward biased. Okay, now if once you recognize the diode, is which diode, which one are forward biased and which one are reverse biased, then you can easily draw the current flow path. Okay, so this current flow through this. At this point, this is reverse bias, there is no current. So it flows through the diode D1. So here it is reverse bias, there is no flow. So there is the reverse leakage current in reverse bias, but it is zero, exactly zero, which is very, very small. So therefore, no current through the reverse bias. So you have to continue here. Continue. Then it flows downward through the RL. As current flows through the RL, it develops the voltage VL across the load RL. VL or VO, whatever it notation you can use. Then it returns back here. Then this diode D4 is forward biased. It flows through the diode. Then it reverses back. Then here, then it completes its path up to negative terminal. So current flows through the diode D1, RL, then D4, and then negative terminal. Okay, how it flows? The current flow. Okay, current flow from positive terminal of secondary. From positive terminal of secondary, then it goes through diode D1. Okay, then it goes through RL. Then it goes through diode D4. Okay, through the diode D4, and then negative terminal of secondary. Okay, so this is the current flow path. So through D1, RL, through D4, and then to the negative terminal. Okay, so this is at positive half cycle. Okay, so this total is at positive half cycle. Okay, so you can give the names A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L. So in the textbook, these are given like this. So here it flows. So you can give the name A, B, C, D, and you can draw the write down the path A to B, B to C, C to D. Better way, you have to write here from the positive terminal of battery through diode D1, through RL, D4, and then negative terminal of battery. So it is very easy, better than A, B, C, D by writing these notes. Okay, so at the negative half cycle we are going to see now. Okay, so at the negative half cycle, let us see what will be happening. So the same diagram is here, only I am drawing this secondary. So at the negative half cycle, we very well know that lower terminal of secondary becomes positive and upper terminal becomes negative. Okay, so by using the same criteria, now we are going to find out which one diode is forward bias and which one is reverse bias. Simple thing, these diodes are here forward bias, you get reverse bias. Okay, so these reverse bias, you will get the forward bias, but you have to find out is it true or not. Okay, so this positive potential is connected to anode of diode D2. So by using this criteria, if anode is high, it is forward bias. So diode D2 is now forward biased. Okay, the same higher voltage is connected to cathode of D4. So cathode is high, so it is reverse biased. Okay, then if negative terminal, now it is connected to anode of this, so opposite of this one. Okay, so negative terminal is So negative terminal is at anode, then here when high it is forward bias, so if it is low then it is reverse bias. So negative terminal is connected to anode, so it becomes here reverse biased. So this negative terminal is now lower potential, better way you have to say lower potential. So this lower potential is now connected to cathode of this diode D3, so it gets forward biased. Okay, so now this gets forward biased, so because of negative is connected to cathode. So here if cathode is at higher potential, you will get it is reverse bias. But here what happens, the cathode is at lower potential, so when cathode is at lower potential, it is opposite. So it is here it is reverse biased with high, and then it is forward biased with low. So therefore now D1 and so here D4 is now reverse biased, D3 and D2 are forward biased. So then you can easily find the current flow. So it starts from the positive terminal of the secondary, or you can say that higher potential of the secondary, then current flows through here up to here, it is reverse biased, then it flows through the diode D2. So here are two paths, from this one and from this one, but it is reverse biased, so there is zero current. So it flows, continue, then RL, okay, then it is just like puzzle. Okay, so here it is reverse biased, then it comes up to here, then flows to the forward bias, and then here it is reverse bias, so it continues, and so here it is forward bias and up to here negative. Okay, so it is there like a puzzle to finding the path. Okay, it is very simple. Okay, so flows through this diode D2, then RL, then here it is reverse bias, so it comes here, then forward D3, and then up to the negative one. So at the negative half cycle, current flow. So now right here, how current flows? Current flow from now say positive terminal of secondary, positive terminal of secondary, then it continues to through the diode D2. Okay, then after D2 to the RL, then through the RL, so this through the RL. Okay, then it through the, so better to write THROUGH, just I am writing here THR dash. Okay, flow through the diode T3, then up to negative terminal of secondary. Okay, from positive terminal of secondary through diode D2, through RL, through D3, and up to negative terminal of secondary. Okay, it flows like this. So this is the working of the bridge rectifier. So you can observe here at both the half cycles, current through the RL in the same direction. Okay, so at the positive half cycle, current flows in this direction. So here also at the negative half cycle, it flows like this. Okay, so that means we can say that, so here current started from this point, so here current started from this lower point. So this is bidirectional current, so direction is this one, now it is this one. So this bidirectional current is converted into unidirectional. So that's why more precisely we can say that rectifier converts bidirectional current into unidirectional current. But briefly we can say that the rectifier convert AC into DC. But precisely, exactly we can say that the bidirectional current is converted into unidirectional. Okay, so the diagram is same for input and output waveform here. So look at here, if suppose this is input which is from the secondary output, okay, is secondary voltage, okay, now then output will be the same. Okay, so here four diodes are used. Then okay, at the positive half cycle, so you can write here D1 and D4 is forward biased and D2, D3 is reverse biased. So here opposite D1, D4 is reverse biased and D2, D3 is forward biased. Okay, so in this way we get the output DC. Actually same thing with this rectifier also. Okay, so this centered FLV rectifier, same thing happened here. It is not a pure DC, it is pulsating DC. So you can say that it is not a pure, it is pulsating DC. Okay, it is pulsating means continuous changing. It is not a pure DC, it is a pulsating DC, and these also known as ripples. Okay, so here only we are going, in this 11th only we are going to see the working of half wave rectifier, then center tap full wave rectifier and then bridge rectifier. So we are going to see the parameters, what are the parameters exactly, how we are going to differentiate between in these with the parameter, that we are going to see in the 12th. Okay, so just we are going to see the working of these three rectifiers. So just you have to keep in mind that the rectifier converts AC into DC, or main precisely it converts bidirectional current into unidirectional current. Okay, so we get the same thing here as that of the center tap full wave rectifier. Okay, so we are using here four diode with a simple transformer. So this is up to the three bridge rectifiers. Now this first chapter of this second paper is completed now. Okay, in that chapter we studied about the semiconductors, p-type n-type semiconductors, p-n junction diodes, forward reverse bias and these rectifiers. Okay, so now, so this is all about the first chapter from the second paper. Okay, so in our next lecture we are going to start the chapter number 4. Okay, chapter number 4 from the paper first. Okay, so which is electronic components. We are going to study about the different electronic components in the paper first. Okay, so here, so it is very easy chapter. Okay, so directly we started the fourth chapter because we need the different, what are the components used in electronics, and we should know about that. Okay, so this fourth chapter from the first paper, we are going to continue in the next lecture. Okay, just you can read before listen my video. Okay, or before watch my video, you have to read this all. So we are going to discuss about the electronic components. So these are the only electronic components we are going to study in the 11th. So it is divided in two parts, passive components and the active component. Okay, the passive components are resistor, capacitor and inductor and their types. So here active components are electron tubes. So we very well know that these electron tubes are totally outdated. Okay, these tubes are totally outdated, we don't bother about that. So now we are going to switch to semiconductor. Already we have studied in the paper 2 first chapter, that is diodes and transistors. So there are different types of transistor. These are the active components and these are the passive components. So why it is known as passive component, why it is called as active component, we are going to see in the next lecture. Okay, before to come for my next lecture, you are going to read about this, what is the actual components. Okay, so we are going to stop here and let us see the component, electronic component, in my next lecture. Okay, so thank you.